Hello and welcome back to another Reality Check VR video. Today we're going to be talking about how you can take any photo and turn it into a 3D photo and do cool stuff like this. That's right, we're gonna show you not only how to put it into Facebook, but use other programs like Blender and just do really cool things for free and really easily as well. So let's go ahead and jump right in and I'll show you how you can do this. And as you can see right now, basically this is just an animation. I took a few camera frames and put keyframes around a couple different photos that I had imported in here and it turned into this this fun thing right here. So anyways, you can do all kinds of cool things with your own photos and we're gonna start looking at how to do that right now. Anyway, all you need to do videos like that or to do cool things like this and even making 3D photos in Facebook is just to have an image and then to have a depth image, which just looks like that. It's like a black and white image. This basically tells the software how far to put different parts of the texture, so it knows exactly how to shape the image.
Yeah.
Okay, so here we have this beautiful AI-generated image of Jillian, and you can see from it that she's in the foreground, and in the background there is a house that's pretty far behind her. And if we go over to the depth map, or the depth field, whichever you like to call it, you can see that the background is very black, and she is basically white, gray, with different hints of different opacities of that. And you can see right here, the reason is because obviously her face is going to be in front of where her hair is in the back, and her front shoulder is going to be in front of, well, her back shoulder, right? So that's what you're seeing right there with those different textures. And then when we put these two images together into Facebook, it's gonna then know what to do, or put them into Blender, either or. So I'm just gonna show you what that looks like right here. So here you can see in the folder, I've got the jills.png and the jills_depth.png. And as I said, as long as it's named the same with underscore depth, it will be able to work. And you can even see like this one over here, comfyui00139_, so this one is _depth, you know, png, and of course that's how you're going to get that one to work. So if I take these two files right here, the jills and the jills depth png, and I take both of them and I drag them over into Facebook, all I have to do is just drop them, and you're gonna see both of them go in, and then it's gonna realize that those are actually two photos that go together, and it's gonna start creating the 3D photo. That's really all you have to do. We'll just go ahead and if you can actually test it with your mouse right here and just move it around, it looks pretty good. But I'm gonna go ahead and hit the post button so we can see it for ourselves. When we're actually scrolling up and down, you can see the photo has that kind of effect going on it when you go up and down. Super cool. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna do one more, different ones like that. The two photos go in there and instantly, 3D photo right there. You got to have the base photo named normally and then the second depth photo _depth. Drag and drop. All it does is go right in, works really, really easy. And it's nice and simple. As you're moving up and down now, you've got all of a sudden got these 3D photos added. It doesn't matter if they're photos that are real photos or AI generated photos. This process will work as long as you have the depth map. Okay, now, if you don't have a depth map, what do you do? Let's go into that. So if you have A1111 or ComfyUI, you're gonna be able to do this on that software. But if you don't, you can also do this through your browser with software called LeahPix. And all you have to do is just sign in and for free. Once you've signed in, you can click upload over here and you just have to upload a photo. So all I'm gonna do is click on this photo right here. And what it's gonna do is it's gonna take that photo and it's gonna then convert it into a depth map photo. And you can see it's already got some movement right here. And the best thing is if you go over here to the left side and you click on depth map, you can see exactly what it's doing. It's kind of highlighting your character and you can use some of these settings to hone it in. But what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna go back to the edit and I'm gonna click over here on share. And when you click on share, it does this amazing thing where not only does it give you the depth map if you want the depth map by itself, which I do want on this, if I click on Facebook 3D, it's going to then tell me, it's going to give you both of the photos. I hit save and it's gonna do exactly that. It's gonna give you one photo with one name and the depth photo with the exact same name, _depth. And all you have to do is then drag and drop both of those into Facebook. So let's go ahead and try that. So here we go, dragging and dropping both of those photos that just popped out from that program right there. And instantly we've got a 3D photo on Facebook that works really, really well. But as you can see right here, the sharpness of the edges around my body aren't quite perfect. And because of that, there's other ways to also get depth of field photos. And I'm gonna show you one of the alternative ways to do that. As always, I will be putting all of the links in the description for everything I'm showing you guys right now. And I would be remiss, I almost forgot, this super simple depth map viewer program. It's available in your browser. All you have to do is just drag and drop the photo and the depth map in here where it says choose your files, your original photo file, and then of course your depth map file. And then it'll give you a cool little GIF like this and actually just make your image 3D right here and there. And that's really, really cool. You can change all the parameters. And I think that's just a really cool small program. So I wanted to show that to you guys real quick, and we'll keep moving on. So for those of you who do have Comfy UI or A1111, all you have to do is use the control net. And in control net, we have the depth of field. And in A1111, it's pretty straightforward. All you have to do is just select the depth of field, and it will automatically give you the post-processing image of the depth of field. If you're using Comfy UI, it doesn't automatically do that. So there's a very simple way to get the pre-processing image, as you can see right here on the screen. And once I'm in this moment, all I have to do is just drag and drop. We'll just show you for the sake of it. I can drag and drop an image on here, and then all it's going to do is take it and put it into the depth preprocessor, which I got through a very simple process, and it spit it out right here. So how did I get this to work? All I had to do was go over to the GitHub, or if you don't want to do GitHub stuff, you can go over here to Civit AI, and you can download the 319-byte file, very, very small file. It is the Comfy UI Manager, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click the download button, and it's going to download this file onto my computer. All right, method one here, we just download it and extract it. Or it says put the install manager for portableversion.bat file into the directory where we have the startup file, okay? All right, so you're just gonna drag and drop that file over into your Comfy UI Windows portable area. And once it's sitting right here, you're just gonna double click it and it's going to install. And that's all you have to do. If you're running Comfy UI, make sure to turn it off and turn it back on. And once you start Comfy UI again, you're gonna have this wonderful little manager section right here. All we have to do is click on the manager. If you're already in something that you don't have the nodes for, you're just gonna have to click on install missing custom nodes, because it's gonna see what's in there that you don't have. If you want to do what I'm telling you right now, you're just gonna go to install custom nodes, and then you're gonna scroll down just a little bit to where it says control net preprocessors. That's right, control net preprocessors. All you have to do is click the install button. Mine's already installed, so you don't see that right here. Click the install button, wait a little bit of time until it's finished installing, and then restart Comfy UI. You're gonna wanna start it from scratch again. It might install a few things and take a little bit of time to get started, but once it's back at its main page, you're gonna be ready to go. So this plugin allows you to automatically download any of the ControlNet preprocessors that you need. All you have to do at this point in time is, if you wanna build it yourself, you just literally type in the word depth, and you're gonna see that there is one depth preprocessor available, and all that allows you to do is take an image into it and then put an image out of it, which, as you can see right above, is all we're doing with this one right here. So we're putting an image into it, and it's giving us an image out. And if I take these two images together again and I put them in one, I can then do really cool things like 3D Facebook photos, 3D GIFs. Not only are they interactive, but they're really fun and cool to look at. Lastly, the one thing we didn't really quite go over just yet is we can put them into Blender, as I'm showing you right here, and you can do this kind of stuff. I mean, this is my favorite thing out of all, is being able to put it into video form and to be able to do different cool things with it. So if you want to know how to do something like this, I'm going to show you very quickly how to do that. Of course, we can do more in-depth tutorials in the future, but right now I'm just gonna try to do it as quickly as possible for all of you who are watching. So if you wanna take your 3D photos and move the camera around and make cool videos with them, all you have to do is download Blender for free right here, get it installed, and once Blender is up and running on your computer, you're gonna jump into the interface just as you are right here. I just deleted the cube that was in the middle, and it's a pretty simple, straightforward process, right? At the moment is one file that you're gonna need to download, and that is this plugin. And this plugin is available from Lady Poly. And basically what it is it allows you to import depth maps. And then over here on the right side, it says download raw file. So I'll click that button. It's going to download the import depth map zip. And I'm actually gonna put these files in my Google Drive as well, so you'll have alternate ways to find them. Once you have that zip file, all you're gonna do is go over here into your edit, into preferences. Into preferences, right here in the middle, there's a section called add-ons. In add-ons, you're gonna click on install, and then when we get to install, we're gonna move our way over to that folder. All right, there, I found it. All right, so I'm just gonna go ahead and find that exact zip folder right there and click install add-on. And when I click that, it's gonna install it into my Blender interface. And now, when I go over here to file, import, I've got this spot that says import depth map. All right. And there's two ways to do this. You can have a side-by-side image, which looks something like right here. If you have the original image on the left and the depth field or the depth map image on the right, and you put this in there as one, it'll just take it and know exactly what to do with it. If you have them as separate files, as we generally do with this workflow, you're just gonna make sure to click up here, separate depth map, right there, and that's gonna tell it you're gonna be putting in two files. First the image, and then the depth map. I'm gonna go ahead and click on Jill's for the image, and then it's gonna say, okay, and where is the depth map? So I'm gonna go ahead and go in there and make sure we click on that depth. And then if I scroll in, you can see right here, it's just imported this structure. And I think that's phenomenal. The fact that it's just working so easily. If you go back here into layout and you wanna see it in the textured mode also, you can also go up here in the right corner. Here we go, move that over a little bit. Up here, you can click on these different buttons in the top right, and that's gonna change whether it's in like the, basically the wireframe, the viewport shading, or the actual texture mode. So that's all you have to do to get those guys in there. And then of course, if you want to move the camera around, you're gonna have to go over into the animation section and then make sure you've got the camera selected. Same thing as before. And then you'll have to sit there and add keyframes as you go. So anyways, I'm not gonna do an in-depth tutorial on exactly how to do all those things right now, because I wanna make this video quick and concise. I just wanted to show you how easy it is to do something like this. And of course, not only making 3D Facebook photos, but being able to take 3D photos and do just about anything you want with them. I mean, really, it's the sky's the limit with what you can do with this stuff. And so if you guys have any questions on this right now, I'm gonna go ahead and keep trying to make more cool content. And I've got a few different workflows coming up to show people how to take photos of your friends, of family, of loved ones, and basically do really cool stylizations with them with a very, very simple workflow. So stay tuned and check out the channel. Also, all the descriptions are available. I do have a Patreon if you want to support it, but nothing is gatekept. So, you know, feel free to support it if you want. You certainly don't have to. And I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. Until then, wait. Let's do the proper camera scene. All right, bye.